Good morning. It is my pleasure to welcome all of you to the annual scientific symposium of the Tsai Neurosciences Institute here at Stanford. This is an annual celebration for us, a celebration of science. It's an occasion for gratitude for the outstanding speakers who have joined us today. And it's an opportunity to strengthen our community in a unique new format at a unique time. And I'm going to start simply by stating the obvious, which some people say is what I do best. This has been one hell of a year. It is difficult now to remember where we were as a community a year ago. At the time of our last symposium in October 2019, we were looking forward to an unprecedented year of opportunity for neuroscience at Stanford, including dedicating the new Stanford Neurosciences building, moving 18 laboratories into it, and creating several new community labs that would serve the entire campus neuroscience community and become a hub of creativity and dissemination of cutting-edge technologies. Little did we know. In March, only a month after a beautiful building dedication on February 11th, the magnitude of the COVID crisis crashed in on us with shelter-in-place orders from Santa Clara County and the state of California and the emptying of our campus. In one of the greatest ironies in my life, my first duty upon moving into the building, which I and many others had worked on for 6 years, was to shut it down. Then beginning in May, we were able to slowly and cautiously reopen, putting health and safety first at all times. Many of us faced and are still facing new complexities as we try to school children at home while juggling demanding jobs. And as if these challenges were not enough, we all experienced a clarion call to action on racial justice issues that emerged from tragic events in several of our cities in the spring, making it clear that we as a nation and as a local neuroscience community have unfinished business to engage in this exceedingly important arena. And layered on top of all of this, our national political situation has added stress and anxiety for most of us. The beautiful building dedication ceremony in February now seems like 3 years ago, literally, not 8 months. But as we have ridden this roller coaster together for the past 8 months, there have been so many concrete instances of fortitude and hope for which I am so deeply grateful to all of you. Your gallantry and your seriousness of purpose in shutting down the very scientific activity that we love most, I've seen that in spades. Your puckish good humor and faithful cooperation as the weeks of shutdown turned into months has been remarkable. Your determination to make the time count by getting on with the science despite the obstacles, and your care for each other during these difficult times have all impressed me far more than I can tell you. I really enjoy my tours around the building most days and seeing the young people, especially the students, the postdocs, the staff who are carrying on with science in a very difficult time. And I admire those of you who cannot come onto campus and yet are working hard to carry on the science remotely. I can honestly say that I admire and I'm deeply grateful for the grace and the courage and the tenacity that all of you have shown during this trying time. Thanks to all of you. This has been a testament to the strength of our community, but I do believe that the best is yet to come for our community. I don't think any of us are kidding ourselves. There will be more trying times for us in the coming year, but I'm confident that we can weather them and come out on the other side a year or so from now as stronger, more focused people with a greater clarity of purpose for our lives and for our careers, and we will make that journey together. Other generations before us have faced their own great challenges and met them. We can rise to the great challenges of our own generation, which are in front of us now. All of this brings us to this day in October of 2020, the 7th annual symposium of the Tsai Neurosciences Institute. Our theme this year is the neurobiology of disease, and we have a sterling set of 6 speakers teed up here, ready and eager to go. We have 3 distinguished guests from outside Stanford, Michael Kahana from Penn, Amy Bastian of Johns Hopkins, and Walter Koroshetz, the director of the National Institute of Neurological Diseases and Stroke. And then we have 3 outstanding speakers from inside Stanford, Michelle Monnier from the Department of Neurology and Neurological Sciences, Professor Karen Parker, who's from the Department of Psychiatry, and Professor Todd Coleman, who is currently at UCSD, but will be joining our bioengineering faculty next July. These speakers will report their latest results on the neurobiology of disease, from molecular analysis of brain tumor mechanisms all the way to neuroengineering approaches to stroke recovery and to gastrointestinal diagnosis. In addition, we will have a virtual poster session that features our students and postdocs and our annual SAMI Quo Awards for the outstanding papers from our postdocs and grad students in the past year. The poster session is something I would like to highlight. We will use a small group meeting software tool from the company Gather. I have been boning up on that this week, and I encourage all of you to experiment with this and come to the poster session. It may well be the best model for realistic scientific encounter and conversation in the coming year that allows people to move around the way you would at a natural poster session and converse in small groups and bump into people and talk to people. So I really call out that poster session that happens right after lunch and invite all of you to attend. I will see you there. So we are honored to have these speakers today, and I am eagerly anticipating their talks. Before beginning the symposium, we pause for a, I think it's appropriate to pause for a public recognition that Stanford sits on the ancestral and unceded lands of the Muwekma Ohlone tribe. This land was and continues to be of great importance to the Ohlone people. Consistent with our values of community and diversity, and cognizant of the current moment in our nation's history, we gladly acknowledge, honor, and make visible the university's relationship to Native peoples. And now, without further ado, I'm going to turn the platform over to Professor Marion Buckwalter of the Departments of Neurology and Neurosurgery, who took the lead in planning this symposium today and will introduce our first speaker. Marion is a clinical scientist whose research focuses on stroke and stroke recovery mechanisms. She serves ably on the WUSI Executive Committee, and I am so grateful for her dedicated efforts on the XCOM and in bringing this symposium together. So Marion, over to you, and off we go.